Hello everybody, welcome to this video on Unacademy. Today I will be talking to you all about how to read the Hindu in 60 minutes. This video is presented to you by me, Lakshmi. This is a brief introduction about myself. I have secured All India rank 45 in the civil services examinations this year and All India rank 50 in the Indian Forest Services examinations this year. So if you are somebody who's looking at how to read the Hindu fast, or where should I focus on, what are the important pages where I should give more importance to, then yes, you are at the right video. But before I start off, I have a small announcement to make. That is, I would be teaching live on Unacademy Plus platform. Here, I would be handling various courses related to gender studies preparation for civil services examinations. By subscribing to my course, apart from mine, you would also be able to access various courses by top educators in our country, and these courses are created in a more comprehensive manner so that this is a one-stop destination for prelims, mains, as well as for interview, such as this course on economy by Mrunal Patel. Then there's a course on international relations and internal security by Ayush. And these are some of the top educators on the platform, and there are courses by Roman Seni as well. Apart from this, test series are also provided on the platform for both paper 1 as well as paper 2. However, these test series are designed in such a format so that you are able to constantly evaluate as well as check where you stand in this preparation on a weekly basis. So all you have to do is to subscribe to Unacademy Plus, and by using my name as a referral code, you can also get a 10% discount on your annual subscription to Unacademy Plus. So please remember that I would be teaching live on Unacademy Plus platform on various subjects related to gender studies preparation for civil services mains examination, and by using my name as a referral code, you can also get access to courses by various other top educators on the platform for your civil services preparation. So the code is Lakshmi. Okay, so let's get started. Firstly, everybody asks me this question, you know, why do I have to read only the Hindu? Why not something else? Okay, so let's look at why the Hindu. Firstly, from an examination perspective, around 15 to 30 questions come directly from the current affairs, which can be solved if you read the Hindu on a daily basis. So once you start reading the Hindu, you know that how an issue is progressing on a day-to-day basis. So this would help you to eliminate answers, eliminate different options, and get the right answer in a preliminary examination. But apart from that, why does everybody choose the Hindu? This is because trivial issues are being avoided, okay? And in civil services, areas of national concern are very important. So that is given more importance, okay? The editorials are very well analyzed, okay? So because the editorials are very well analyzed, it helps you to create very strong opinions, which is important for both mains as well as for the interview preparation in civil services. Now, let's go on to the next topic, that is, what are the mistakes that I did in my first attempt while reading the newspapers? This is important because you must not commit the same mistakes, okay? And learn from mine so that you are able to decide what to do and what not to do while reading the Hindu. Firstly, cutting articles and keeping them in a file. In my first year of preparation, I had almost every editorial as well as those on the perspective page cut, and I kept them in a file. And trust me, even to this day, I haven't opened them. So any material or a resource, if it is kept unused and you're not even revising them one day before the exam, it is of no use, and do not even try them. Okay. Next is making notes of editorials. I do not believe in making notes of the editorials, because editorials are written in such a way that you are able to generate your own opinions and add value addition. So I will tell you which is the best way to tackle editorials, and not making notes of the same thing which is given in the newspapers. Okay. And reading editorials over and over again. What happens is, we tend to spend a lot of time here because everybody tells us that editorials are very important in civil services examinations. So if we do not understand a particular news article, what we tend to do is we read them repetitively over and over again, yet we do not understand the crux of the article. So there is a way out, and I'll tell you how to tackle these editorials in this video. Next, spending a lot of time with the newspapers. I generally believe that even 60 minutes is more and you should tackle them within the max to max 60 minutes. So do not spend the whole day with the newspapers because it is not going to give you enough returns. It is just a good habit and a good way to start your civil services examination preparation. Next. So now next question is, what is the ideal time to be devoted and how must a newspaper be read? Okay. Firstly, you should know that any magazine cannot replace the newspapers. So do not even try them, even the monthly magazines, because newspapers cover an issue on a day-to-day basis and no magazine is actually a substitute for this. So how did I divide my time? I used to spend around 30 to 40 minutes with the newspapers every day, of which I reserved 15 minutes for the editorials, wherein I used to analyze the editorials and create my own opinions. Okay, this way I made making newspapers as a habit. Because just say they're asking you about some new species which has been discovered in the Western Ghats and you remember that picture which was in the newspaper, you'll be able to tackle that better. This way, newspaper also helps you to create a good pictorial memory in your brain so that you are able to tackle such questions in the civil services examination. Next, focus on the important areas, okay, and skim through the rest. Yeah, we generally tend to see the rest and we tend to invest more time there, but that is not important because we need to give importance only to the important areas. And I will tell you what are the important areas in a newspaper. Reading one newspaper is enough. Why? Because we see that for economics, business line is good, and then for opinions, Live Mint is good, Hindustan Times is good, Times of India is good. Yes, they all are good. But what is relevant for us, which is used by a lot of toppers or aspirants, it is Hindu, right? So you can read only the Hindu and restrict yourself only to the Hindu. But especially while reading editorials, it is very, very important that you have a pen in your hand. Okay, so just when after you read an editorial, write your own opinion and then see what you've learnt new. And in case you feel that those opinions are good, write down only the keywords in a book. Okay, say something about poverty and you know one or two new points. Take a new book and then write poverty and write only those keywords. That will suffice for this examination. Next, what are the important areas that you must focus on in a newspaper? Firstly, it is the editorial or the op-ed, means opposite editorial page or the perspective page in the Hindu, which is very, very important because it gives you good analysis of the articles and it also helps you to generate your own opinions. Secondly, you need to focus on Supreme Court judgments. Okay, say with respect to the Sabarimala issue or something related to Aadhaar, what is the Supreme Court actually saying? So that is important. Issues of national and international importance becomes very important in civil services exam. But if you are taking a state public service exam, then you need to focus on regional issues as well. Parliamentary debates. Say some bill is being referred to the select committee or the ad hoc committee of the parliament, or the amount of parliamentary debates is going down. Such issues are very important. Next is government policies as well as schemes, which is the government has brought out. Next is optional related. Your optional could be PAPAD, it could be anthropology, etc. So if my optional was anthropology, usually on the life page, some new discovery or something related to Neanderthal, etc. would come up. So I used to look at the life page. So it depends on your optional. If your optional is PABAT, then you need to focus more on governance, national issues, etc. So if it is PSIR, you need to focus on international relations. So deciding on your optional, you need to also invest more time on those areas to know what are the recent developments. Next, social issues. Okay, social issues, say some new report has come. Okay, you need to invest time there and say some women's illiteracy rate is going up. So if there's an article on that, why is it going up? Which state is doing better, etc. Surveys and reports, okay, which comes up now and then on the newspapers. Ethical examples. Okay, this is just say when you're skimming through the newspaper, you find some example which is really very interesting. Like there was recently, I think about 7 or 8 months back, there was this African national who was given French citizenship because he tried to save the life of a child. So that is a good ethical example. You can quote them in your answers. So this way you could also pick up ethical examples and go through the mains syllabus. This is very important so that you know which comes in GS1, what comes in GS2, GS3, etc. And you're able to look for those news. Okay. What must be avoided? Firstly, if you are not somebody who's preparing for state public services examinations, then you can skip this. This occupies a big chunk in the newspaper, so that you can skip that. Next, political news. Okay, it is not really important from civil services perspective, so you can skip that. And non-priority areas which are not given importance either ways in Hindus, like the film reviews or celebrity interviews, etc., you can skip all that. And even news related to sports, persons in news, etc., it's not questions based on sports, etc., are not asked, so you can skip even that. Next, I will be telling you about in a Hindu newspaper which are the pages that you need to focus more on. See, this is how a Hindu newspaper has been designed. They have, usually it is 18 pages, okay? The first page is the important headlines which has happened previous day comes up, right? So you just need to skim through the headlines and that would be enough. Page 2 to 6 carries usually city news, state news in that order. So if you are somebody who is not preparing for state exams, you need not do that too. Page 7. It has related to nation, focus on them and look for any new policies as well as judgments. Okay, this page is very, very important, page 7. So, because it carries national news, so you need to do page 7 properly. So, this is the first important page. Next is on page 8. Okay, this is the editorial page. Here you need to focus more on gathering opinions and also formulate your own. Sometimes what happens is this page looks really scary and we tend to read the editorials over and over again. So that is not very important. Even the vocabulary which they use is not very important, because when you are writing an answer, you can write them in a very simple format. Then page 9. The page which is just opposite to the editorial page, there also you have few analyzed articles, you can read them too. And page 10 and 11, this is not important because it carries political news, which is not very important from the examination perspective, so you can skip that. So till now, the important pages were 7, 8, 9. So we've got only 3 important pages till now. Next, page 12. It carries news related to international relations, but remember that the news related to international relations, the development is at a very, very slow pace. So you can either read this or you can also read Current Affairs magazine and the effect would be the same. So page 12 is okay. And page 13 and 14. This page is generally neglected by most of us because it carries news related to economy as well as business. Here, the macroeconomic and as well as the fiscal policies of the government, industrial growth, say something is happening to the textile industry, agricultural growth, India's export, etc., has been given focus, or even the monetary policy of the government. But what we tend to do is we tend to skip this page, which must be avoided. Page 13 and 14 must be given adequate importance too. But page 15 and 16, we have sports news, which can be avoided. Next is page 18, which is on life. So everything here is usually on a lighter note. So in case if something strikes your curiosity, you can always read them. And also remember, in the Hindu, it is very important to read the science and technology edition, which comes weekly. So the most important pages in the Hindu are 7, 8, 9, 12, okay, 13, 14. So it's just 6 pages, and don't you think even 60 minutes is a lot? So you need to cut down on your time and invest more time somewhere else. So I was telling you previously that there's an easier way to do editorials. So I'll tell you how to do it. Okay. What I did was this. I used a lot of internet. Firstly, it saves a lot of time. What I used to do was, in the early morning before I went to the library, I used to read the newspaper fast, maybe in 20 minutes or so, and then go to the library. By the time I came back home in the evening, I used to watch a 10-minute lesson on Unacademy, saying this is the news analysis and this is how the editorial has been analyzed. So anyways, I had read the whole editorial in the morning. So if at all I had missed anything, I could add that now. So this way, I generally took about 30 to 35 minutes. So you can also do the same and save a lot of time and invest that time somewhere else. Okay, So I would be teaching live on Unacademy Plus platform, and by using my code you can also avail a 10% discount on the courses for your annual subscription, and you can also get access to courses by various other top educators on the platform. Lastly, these are some of my parting words. Make newspaper reading a routine every day. Let it not be restricted only to civil services examination preparation, because it is said that a good newspaper is like a nation talking to itself. So if you want to be a well-informed person, you must read them irrespective of whether your preparation is limited to civil services or not. Thank you.